We'll derive the unsteady state mass balance for a tubular reactor, and then the energy balance has a similar procedure. And so this is going to be a general derivation, so we'll include the possibility of radial gradients and the possibility of dispersion in the axial direction. So what we're going to do is do a balance on a differential volume, but it has to be an annular region. So the idea is if I am looking at an angle, flow would be in this direction. And now we're going to work in terms of velocity instead of volumetric flow rate because we're allowing for radial gradients. And so R radial directions this way, Z is the axial direction. And this annular volume that we're looking at is going to have a thickness that we'll look at as delta Z, and then we'll shrink it down after we've written the equation. And it's going to have a radial distance delta R. The terms are going to appear in the equation then are something that D is not a diffusivity as we normally think of it. We refer to it as an effective diffusivity. And so we're allowing for the possibility that we have a packed bed reactor. There's lots of mixing and turbulence, and that causes some dispersion, some gradient flow due to gradients. And we'll see as we look at the equations what that means. But we're going to do the same kind of material balance, but allow now, of course, unlike the simple plug flow reactor, we're allowing for things to change with time. So again, we're going to look at just accumulation as material flowing in and out, and then generation due to reaction, right? We're doing the balance on one component. And so now let's look at the various terms. So what we're going to say is in some increment of time, the concentration within this volume will change. And keep in mind, it's a small delta Z and delta U. So this change is some small change. The volume that we're looking at, 2 pi R, delta R, and delta Z, that's the volume of this annular region. So 2 pi r, then the circumference, and then the delta r, and the delta z that gives us the area. So we're going to see a change in a concentration, right? And this is due to, of course, all the terms on the right side. And the change is multiplied by the volume. So the term for flow in, we're going to allow for several terms. So unlike our earlier calculation, the flow in term is going to include convection, namely flow, because we have some velocity, radial diffusion. In general, we can imagine the diameter reactor is very big, there's a radial gradient, and then axial diffusion. We know there's a gradient in concentration in the axial direction. As a result, there can be diffusion that changes the concentration in the reactor. So this flow in term is going to be a combination of the convection term, velocity in the z direction, concentration. So velocity times area times concentration is our volumetric flow rate times concentrations. So that's a molar flow rate, like we looked at before. 2 pi r delta r. That's the area, right? That's the area of the face of this annular region, this of the face that we're looking at. We have flow coming perpendicular to that. So it's coming in at z. And then we're looking now at the amount that flows in some interval time delta t. All right, since we're looking at a transient term. The other flow, if you like, due to the axial diffusion in the same direction, is due to a diffusivity, and we could call it diffusivity in z direction. And because we have a concentration, same area as before, same evaluated at z, same delta t. So diffusivity times concentration gradient. And now there's a minus sign here. The minus sign is there because, for example, if the concentration is higher at a higher z, diffusion is actually back to lower z, right? Diffusion is from high concentration to lower. So we have a similar term for diffusion in this annular region due to a radial gradient. So it's the same idea, but now we have to put in the area 2 pi r delta z evaluated at r now. So this is diffusion and for delta t. So I've written down the flow terms out. And note they're the exact same terms, and the only difference is we're evaluating at a different point. So here we're evaluating at z plus delta z. So the flow in z downstream, some small delta z flow out. Likewise, flow in at r, flow out a slightly larger radius, delta r. So flow in, flow out, we have the accumulation term. The only term left is the generation term due to the reaction. And so the generation term would be the rate of reaction times the volume. So 2 pi r, delta z, that's the volume of the annular region. And remember, we're doing the balance for some delta t. So rate of reaction, so many moles per time, per volume, we multiply by the volume, multiply by the time, we get the number of moles. So now we have all the terms for the mass balance. We basically have to substitute in to the balance and simplify. And so we won't go through all the steps of simplification. The important things are we're going to divide. So let me write. We're going to divide once we substitute in. We're going to divide by delta t. And what we're going to do once we substitute in, we're going to look at limits as delta r gets small, delta z gets small, delta t gets small. So we end up with a differential equation. Of course, in this case, it's a partial differential equation. So what I'm going to do is stop and put in the values and then discuss them. So let me, before I continue to put these values, let me mention the rest of the calculation of what we're going to divide by. So we're going to divide by delta t, but we're also going to divide by the volume. So we're going to divide by this 2 pi r delta r delta z. So the 2 pi r is going to cancel out in a lot of the terms, but not all. And then we're going to, with terms, some cases delta r and some cases delta z cancel out also. Okay, so here's the equation with the rearrangement, essentially dividing through by delta t and then the volume, rearranging the terms. And we rearrange the terms, obviously, so they look like, and they're going to become derivatives as we take the limit. So essentially, the same thing that, you know, you did in calculus, took a limit, delta r, delta z, and delta t. We're going to look at the limit as these all go to zero, and then we're going to look at the equation that results. So the left side becomes the partial ca respect to t. Notice these are all partial derivatives because we have three variables in this case, R, Z, and time. And so we have to be careful to use the partial derivatives. So this first term is a partial of the concentration of A, the velocity of Z, respect to Z. And of course, the velocity can change for lots of reasons. Moles changing, temperature changing, pressure changing. And so we have to have the velocity inside this derivative, the derivative of the concentration times the velocity. And so the in this case, right, we're writing a partial derivative. The R is the same at both in this term here. The R canceled out because the R is not changing. We're just looking at changing in the Z direction. The next term now is the dispersion term in the Z direction, this effective diffusivity. And this is the second derivative, with respect to Z here, right? If we look at this term, we have a first derivative, CA respect to Z, and now we're looking at a difference between the value Z plus delta Z minus the value at Z, and we're dividing by delta Z. Again, we're doing it constant R. We have the partial term. And then we have the radial direction. Now, this is different. Now we can't cancel out the R because indeed we're looking at R changing. So if you like, it's a second derivative, but it's a derivative respect to R of R times the derivative of concentration respect to R. And then the last term on the right side is the rate of reaction. And so this completes the balance. And of course, this can simplify in a number of cases, and we'll look at limiting cases. Essentially, if we have no gradient in the radial direction, so this is zero, right? This is our plug flow reactor example. And then if the dispersion defective diffusivity in the Z direction is zero, then we don't have to worry about this second term. And we can write a transient term for a plug flow reactor, the simplest kind, right? So we have change concentration times velocity. And obviously, we could write this in terms of molar flow rates like we've done before. Could look at rearranging this. What might be easier by multiplying everything by area, for example. Okay, so this would be transient plug flow reactor. The other case would be where we just have radial. So we're going to look at steady state. So the partial respect to T are zero. And we're still going to have no gradient. So the change in concentration in the R direction is zero. The diffusivity is very high. There's no gradient. So if we go back to the equation, we're now going to, that term is zero. This term is zero, right? Now our dispersion in the Z direction is important. So left side, we have zero. And I'll stop this and just write the equation down. So here's the steady state equation where we have allow for the possibility of dispersion or diffusion in the Z direction. And so we have now a second order equation. We can write it, since our only variable is Z, right, then we should be able to write this as the change in concentration respect to Z as a longer, a partial derivative. And we can solve this type of equation with the theta, okay? And the energy balance We follow the same ideas to derive it by looking at energy flow in and out, taking the limit, simplifying, dividing through, that type of thing.